Hi, my name is Megan Itavle. I've been making interactive projections for over 15 years, and today I'm going to show you how you can make an interactive hockey game for your floor using any type of projector, a 3D camera, and a Windows computer. All of the links to everything that you need are going to be in the description, and if you like this kind of content and you want to learn more about how to make these types of displays for your business or your event company or your school, all you need to do is follow this channel or contact me directly at info@lumoplay.com and I'll help you with your project. This hockey game has several components that you can customize, pretty much everything that you see. So you'll notice that there's an idle image that shows up when nobody is engaging with the game that tells people what to do. We call that the idle, but you can interpret it as a call to action. As soon as you move, it disappears. And all of the other elements on the floor are also customizable. So you can change the background, you can change the leaderboard, you can change the nets, you can change the size and area of the gameplay area, and you can even change what you're kicking. So if you wanted it to be a ball instead of a puck, that's totally possible. You can change the color of the trail that shows up, and you can also change the particles that show up when you have a goal. There's also audio included with this experience. I'll turn it on for just a second so you can hear it. So this is the hockey audio pack. And you can hear when I hit the puck and when I get a goal. There's also a big horn at the end when you win the game. So let me show you how I made this. The way I made these graphics for the hockey game was on layers. And I'm gonna provide my working file so that you will be able to build these graphics yourself using a size reference. But one of the things that you need to keep in mind is that before you start designing, you need to make sure that you know what the installation computer's resolution is going to be. Because this resolution on my Mac is much, much higher than the resolution of the game that's on the floor. And that can lead to some tricky situations when it comes to the sports template in particular. Most of LUMOplay's motion maker templates are very forgiving, but with the sports template, you want everything to line up pretty much exactly, and any sort of difference in the size of your design file and the size of the actual display that you're going to be playing the game in is going to be really, really obvious. So in this case, my floor is 1920 by 1200, and so I have made a working file that is also 1920 by 1200. If you're going to use this file and your projector is a different resolution, you're gonna have to resize it a little bit and jigger it around to make sure that it'll work. So I design everything on layers in one master file, and you can see the leaderboard and the rink area and the snow area or the background are all different layers. In the end, you're going to export all of your layers into their own files. So the rink will be in its own file, the background image will be in its own file, and the things like the leaderboard and the net images and the game over messaging and the idle image, those are all going to be on their own files as well. If you need really explicit instructions on how to do this, I'm going to post a link to the written tutorial because it'll give you a lot more details about exactly how to size your images and what kind of file types to use and stuff. You can also use background videos, so that's something interesting to play around with. If you decide to do that, definitely check out the article that's linked in the description so that you can make sure that you're rendering your videos at the right compression. Once you're done creating all of the images for your game, you're gonna end up with a folder that looks like this. So as you can see, I've got my background and my game over image and my idle image, which is the call to action that appears when nobody is playing, the scoreboard, the nets, the rink background, and the rink itself. The rink background and the idle image are the only two images that are gonna be the entire size of the display. The others are going to be whatever size you made them at. And you only need one image for the net because it'll duplicate it on either side. Once you have these images, you can launch LUMOplay. When LUMOplay launches, you'll see all of the new apps that we have available. And you can go to the Motion Maker section and look at all of the different templates. The template that we're using today is called Sports. So it's right at the bottom. Just click create. And this will take over your entire screen. I'm going to mute this. There we go. You can preview what you're making while you make it, which is really nice. But it is, again, very important to make sure that the resolution on your design machine is the same resolution as whatever your final installation machine is going to be, especially for sports. For most of the other templates, this doesn't matter, but for sports, as you'll see in a second, things get moved around a lot, and if they aren't lined up exactly right in that resolution, they're gonna look really weird when they're on a different resolution display. The first thing that I like to do when I'm making a game is name it. So I'm going to call this Canada Hockey. I'll start in the overlays section. I'm not adding a logo or a mask to this experience, but I am going to add the idle image. So that's this one right here. And I'm going to make sure that it is not see-through, because the graphic itself, I made it a little bit see-through so that you can see the lines through it. So I'm turning the alpha all the way up. The timeout is also something that you want to keep in mind for this, because with this idle image, it's designed to come back as soon as there's no activity being detected. So if I stop playing for even a second, it comes right back. So it's good to turn this all the way up when you're doing a sports game, because that way, in between the ball moving back and forth and people not moving, you're not going to get that message halfway through the game. It's only going to come when the game is over. I'm going to leave the idle animation on. You can turn this off so that it doesn't kind of bounce forward and backwards the way that it does here, but I am really happy with how that looks. And also, one of my cardinal rules, if you've never made a game with me before, is that especially for floor games, something should always be moving. And that's because otherwise people just think it's a static image being projected on the floor. Interactive floors are still not that common, and so having something that invites people to come play is really important, and movement really catches the eye. I'm gonna collapse the overlays section and replace the background next. So I have two backgrounds in here. I think that's because I accidentally saved two of them. This snow background, I can tell just by looking at it, that's the one I want. And that's because it has a nice little inset area for the rink to sit. I'm done with the background section. I can go into sounds and change this. Right now I have the audio on this computer off so that I don't have to listen to it. But you can actually mute it in the game. So if you don't want any audio in your game, you can turn it off. You can adjust the volume as well. I'm just going to change this to the hockey sound pack. Next, I'll move on to the field. My field graphic is this one called Rink. I'll open that up. And as you can see, it fits very nicely into this little inset area. I actually want to make that a little bit bigger. Not that big. Right there. So that way it looks like it's kind of set in the snow a little bit. Now, this would not reposition properly on a display that is, you know, say quite a bit longer. So it is important to know that for this step what your final resolution is going to be. You can adjust the vertical offset if you want to. I don't really think I need to. Let's move it maybe just a little bit. Yeah, so that it's got the same amount of space at the top and the bottom. And the net graphic, I'm not going to adjust the net size, and I'm just going to leave the graphics that are in here because I think they're the same as the ones that I have saved. I could actually find out. Oh no, these are a little bit different. Yeah, so there's a net graphic. And you can change the net size, and this will actually adjust the amount of space that people have to score a goal on you. So it's kind of nice to make it a little bit more challenging, but if you're making a game for very small children or you want to make something that's a little bit more accessible, you can make that score area bigger. I'm done with the field stuff, and now I'm going to move on to the scoreboard. This is an interesting feature because you can actually change the number of scores it takes to win the game. So I'm going to change it from 3 to 10 because I don't know if you noticed, but it says score 10 goals to win. So I am going to make sure that that's accurate. Before I change anything like the scoreboard size and the text, I am going to put in my own image. So there it is. And it was based on the default image size, so it's pretty much exact, taking up the exact same amount of space, but I can change this as well. So I can adjust where the numbers sit. I can adjust where the score sits, how close it is to the center of this area. And these little reset buttons are really handy because if you want to just test something out and then you're like, oh, I don't like that, trying to get it exactly back to where it was can be kind of fiddly. So you can just click that to get it back. And then the overall scoreboard size, you can adjust that as well. I don't know when, in what situation you would want to have a scoreboard this big, but it's an option. Same thing with the vertical offset. So if you wanted to, oh, I think we already did that one. If you want to change where the numbers sit. So if you had something where they were sitting on top of another element, you would be able to move them up and down. I think that's it for me for the scoreboard. I'm going to go into game over, and that's very simple, just choosing the game over graphic. And I'm not going to see this graphic unless I actually play through the game. So I would have to get 10, I would have to score 10 goals. So I can very easily do that. This is a touch screen, as you can tell. And it is kind of good to like play the game as you're making it, just to make sure that it behaves the way you want it to. And the interactive elements all work properly. And this is the best way for me to see what that game over is going to look like. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, I think that's perfect. I'm really happy with that. I'm going to leave it the size that it is. Now, this ball area is where I would change it to a hockey puck. So I'm going to do that. There's a lot of different balls. Even though we only have 3 sound packs, we do have volleyballs and tennis balls and all kinds of other balls in here. So if you want to make something else with this, you absolutely can. Right now we're just focusing on hockey, but there's a lot of different types of kick things around sort of games that you can make with this template. I'm going to go with an ice hockey puck. The size can be adjusted. So if you want to make the puck giant or very, very small, you can. And it also has settings for the trail here. So I'm actually going to just change this trail to white to go along with the sort of snowy motif that we have going. And I'm going to bump the size of the trail down a little bit so that it's not quite as long of a trail. That looks good to me. So after the ball, the only thing left is the goal scored particles. And I'm not actually going to change these for this game because they're kind of these little crystally things, and I think they go really well with the snow. So I'm going to leave them. But if you wanted to change these, you can. I'll take them out just to show you. So if I go back to a different version of this, I can choose my own particles and now it'll look different, and you can change, you know, the particle size and the rotation speed, and you can vary rotation speeds. You can rotate on any one of the axes or just one or all of them at once. And that gives you different effects as well. But I'm gonna reset this to the defaults. And again, yeah, it's really important to play as you go to make sure that everything is working the way that you want it to. And that's it. Now that I have finished making this and I'm happy with how it looks, whoopsie. A lot of times when people are making games using Motion Maker, they're actually using 2 screens. So these settings would be on a second screen and the game would be on a screen all by itself. But that's not how I'm going to do things. So yeah, I'm done. I'm going to click save. And then I can close this. And you can see the final game in my drafts folder. I can go back in and edit it as long as it's in the drafts folder. The minute I publish it, it no longer is editable. So it's really important that you're done your game before you hit publish. I'm gonna publish that. And once it's uploaded, I'll be able to go to my floor and download it. You'll be able to access the games that you make with Motion Maker on any of your LUMOplay installations. So if you're making something for a client and you want to send it to their system, as long as it's in the same account, you'll be able to do that. You can manage your games remotely that way. I'm just going to click OK, and it will appear when I look for Canada Hockey. There we go. So this was the test one that I did, and here's my final. And I can download that here, or I can download it on the floor and go play it there. That's it for this week. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make this hockey game with me. Please let me know if you have any questions or if you want any help with a project. I'm happy to help. I really, really enjoy doing this stuff. I don't know if you can tell. I will have this game, this exact game, available in the App Store sometime later this week or early next week. I don't want to shoot the video for the app library preview until I'm feeling a little bit better. I had a cold all last week, so I'm going to wait a little bit before I start inviting people back into the space. But yeah, on that note, if you are in Montreal and you want to come and visit me, I'm now accepting guests. And if you want to come over and like learn how to make a game, please let me know. And if you happen to be in the Baltimore area in March, between March 11th and 15th, I will be at the CEC conference in the Tech Playground teaching people how to do this in schools. So there will be some information in the description. If you want to come to that event, please let me know. Again, leave a comment, like, subscribe, share this project with your friends. Anything that we can do to help more people get interactive experiences into places where they're really needed. I'll see you again next week with another video.